I didn't think you were quite up to par. I did have a good time, but...
Oh, go watch Dungeons & Dragons. Go watch one of those fucking shows. Or watch one of those movies, you know, with the misunderstood superhero. You know? Ooh, I have 8-pack abs, but people don't understand me, including my impossibly hot girlfriend. That's what they do now, right? Why are they doing that? I used to like back in the day, they always had a dark side to them, but you know what I mean? They had a beautiful woman. You know, they didn't have to figure out their feelings, all right? They just defeated the bad guy, and then they went away. That's what they did. Now, since post-therapy, all of these goddamn superheroes, man, they all got a fucking... You know what they're like? They're like all those Seattle bands that came out in the early 90s that just sort of dumped their day on you. You know, I want a little more Motley Crue in my superheroes. Or dare I say Poison. Don't need nothing but a good time. Now, those guys were all sad. They were dealing with alcoholism and fucking diabetes and shit like that. They had all kinds of drama. Did they bring that to the stage? No, they did not. They were like, you know what? These people had a rough fucking day. And then what happens? All these Seattle bands got to fucking bring gloom and doom because it rains 9 out of 10 days up there. And they just bring their weather to everybody else. I'm a rock star, but I'm wearing a flannel shirt because I don't want to get the sniffles because I live in Seattle. Oh, sorry. I will never get over those bands knocking all my hair metal bands. You know, that's when I knew I was old, when those guys all came in. And I was like, hey, man, like, where's the tap on solos, man? You know, I don't want to nitpick, but just to let you know, nobody in your band is wearing leather, man. What did I know? I was just an orange kid with a dream. The 80s were over. When the 80s ended, that was it. That was it for me. And ever since then, I've felt like a fucking senior citizen. I'm like the reverse of the last guy that fucking wrote in on this podcast where he's 77, still running around with his dick out. You know, me, you know, I'm ready for a walker. Not going to lie to you. No, I've kept myself in good shape. You know, I do my squats, Obili squat face, you know. I do my sit-ups. I do my obliques. I try to keep the core, you know, going. I eat a salad. I try to stay hydrated. And other than that, if I could just learn to shut the fuck up every once in a while, I think I'd be doing pretty good.